Welcome to Peaceful Warrior Life. My name is Ashley, and in this episode of Backyard Yoga, we practice being kind to ourselves so that we may be kind to others out in the world. Be kind, stay kind. So let's hop on your mat and let's get started. Sitting in a chair or on your couch with your palms up or down, totally up to you, just breathing. But if Balasana is in your practice, go ahead and move to our knees, and our hands are like starfish underneath our shoulders. I'm going to put my knees together and send my booty on back to the back edge of the mat. And just take my hands and stretch them out in front of me. And bring my forehead to the earth. Feeling the stretch. With your fingertips. Really going ahead and dropping in to that breath. Just a little bit back and forth. Or you just might want to find that stillness. Nose and look forward, taking those hands and placing them underneath our shoulders. They're like starfish, so our hands are nice and wide. So placing them underneath our shoulders, our knees are underneath our hips, forming this tabletop position. And then a nice deep inhale, we'll carve a line and look forward with our noses. Dropping that belly, opening up that heart space, and then blowing it all out as we get to a kitty cat pose. Speaking of, there's my kitty cat. Yes. And then looking forward again, carving a line with that nose, and pulling that belly button up and in. And then one more time. Inhaling, looking forward. And blowing it all out. If you'd like to continue on this cat-cow journey that we're on, go ahead and do so. And if you're like, no, I'm really feeling the need to move around a bit, absolutely do so. So you can move around a bit, maybe massaging your hands for a moment, your wrist, or arms. Think about what feels kind you may be like, whoa, the cat-cow feels awesome. I'm going to stay right there. Your choice.
Oof. So, wherever you are, we'll come back to center. Our hands are still like starfish underneath us. Knees are hip width apart. We'll readjust, finding that tabletop. Little bend in those elbows so we're not really locking them in. Just a little bend. Taking this right foot and extending it out behind us, using that core to lift it up. Pretend like we're pushing it into a wall. If this is good, stay right there. If you're like, whoop, I think I just want to put my foot on the ground, absolutely do that too. And taking this left hand and reaching it out in front, like we're shaking someone's hand. Finding that strength, that stability, remembering to be kind. So if this is good, or if this is good, or if this is good, modify it to fit your needs. And we're lifting. And then bringing everything back in. Knee replaced on the earth, hand replaced on the earth. And then if you taking this left leg out, moving it up, right hand goes out, same thing, other side. So remembering those modifications. If this is too much, you can always replace that hand to the earth. If you want to send that back leg out, absolutely do that as well. Working on that strength, igniting that core. And then pulling everything back to center. Good job. Finding that tabletop, we'll bump those left hips out and look over our right shoulder gently. And then rotating back to center, bump those right hips out, looking over that left shoulder. And then coming back to center, taking this right foot out, sending it out nice and long, up, pushing into that wall, left hand goes out. You got it. Finding that strength, that stability. And if this is good, great, stay right there wherever you are in this pose. If you'd like a bit more, you can always bring that knee into the nose, and that arm into the body. And then sending it out nice and long. And then bringing it in again. And sending it out nice and long. And then bringing it in again. And sending it out nice and long. And then we'll replace everything to the ground. If you need to come off of your wrist for just a moment, give yourself a little bit of love, do so. And then we'll find that same thing, other side. So, taking this left leg out and up, right arm goes out and up. And if this is good, stay right there. That bit more, you can bring everything in. Woo, and then send it out. Bring everything in. Send it out. And then one more time. And then we'll bring everything back down to the earth. Moving that booty back into that child's pose again. Pulling those fingertips, pushing them towards the front edge of the mat. Our shoulders are pulling away from our ears. Feeling that stretch. Carving a line with our nose, looking forward. We'll walk these hands back, and then we'll just take our palms, put them straight out in front of us, and do some down, put those fingertips down towards the earth. And
I've heard these called thriller arms before. So down they go. And then let's flip them. Turn those hands up towards the sky, gently pulling on those fingertips. Give our wrist just a little bit of love, of kindness. Rotating them around. Good job.
We'll come back down to our tabletop position. Bump that left hip out again, looking towards the right. Coming back to center. Bumping that right hip out, looking towards the left. And coming back to center. Putting a little fire in those toes. We're gonna let those knees hover. 4, 5. 4, 3, 2. And 1, dropping those knees back down, sending that booty on back to the back edge of the mat, stretching out again, breathing deep. And this time we're going to bring our noses, taking a line, carving it forward, finding a half plank. So you can move your hands out just a little bit if you'd like, or they can stay right where they were. And from here, you've got a couple of options again. So, rocking forward into plank and back into that child's pose, if you'd like. Or when you get all the way up here into plank, to half plank actually, then you'll drop down onto your belly. Your hands are right here beside your chest. Pelvis pushing into the earth, feet pushing into the earth, little bitty baby cobra. And then back down we go, lifting back up into a half plank and moving back into that child's pose. On a deep inhale, coming up again. Now remember, here, this is called a half series, so here you can either go back and forth into child's pose or take that little vinyasa. What feels good for you, moving at your own pace. Making sure to be kind for your own body. And if you're here and you're like, whoop, you know, I think I'm going to do some yogi push-ups or some little crocodile push-ups, absolutely do so. Listen to you. What do you need today? What is being kind look like for you? It's so important for us to really listen and be kind to ourselves. I think that helps us be kinder to others. And if we can start right here on our mats, what a wonderful place to start. We're going to do 2 more of these wherever you are, whatever you are doing. If you are in Balasana Child's Pose and you're like, this is where I want to be, that's awesome. Stay there. And we'll meet back in our child's pose. Taking those hands, moving them out just a little bit more, putting some fire in those toes. We'll very gently pull, move that booty back to the back edge of the mat. First downward dog of the day, pedaling it out, shaking our heads yes and no. Ooh, finding that gentle movement. What feels good for you? And if your heels don't tend to touch the ground, that's okay. The
most important thing is really lengthening that back. So you can always put a little bend in those knees. And then we'll walk forward with our right foot and our left foot, right and left, finding that forward fold. Ooh, feels good. Planting those four corners of the feet into the earth, lifting, rising up, slowly fingertips come and kiss overhead, raining them down by our sides, all the way down they go, palms finding the earth, stepping back with that right foot and that left foot, plank or half plank, yogi's choice, and we're here for 3, 2, going straight to down dog, or taking that little vinyasa. Whew. Pedaling it out. And then walking forward with our left foot and our right foot, left and right, into forward fold again. Here, just feeling the stretch. And if your legs are bent, great. Absolutely let them bend. And if they are straight, fantastic. Listen to you. Be kind to yourself. If you'd like to hold your elbows for a minute, absolutely do so. And then wherever you are, planting those feet into the earth and rolling up very slowly, using that core to come all the way up. Fingertips come and whoa, kiss. Overhead to rain them down by our sides, palms finding the earth, stepping back with that left foot this time, and that right foot, plank pose or half plank, always your choice. And we're here for 3, 2, 1, dropping down to the belly or going straight to down dog. It is totally your choice. We'll meet in down dog, pedaling it out, walking forward with the right foot and the left, right and left, rolling up all the way up very gently, palms come and kiss lightly overhead, raining them down by our sides with a wiggle of those shoulders. Move about, find what feels good for you, stepping back with that right foot, opening it up, finding that external rotation of the hips. Hands are going to come out nice and long. Dropping that center, that finding that center of gravity. And then from here, just lifting everything up and pulling it in. And if this is too much for you and you're like, you know, not really me, you can always stay right here and use your arms, or you can put your arms right here and you can just do your legs. So whatever feels good for you, go for it. Be kind to ourselves. And then to add a little outer layer, you can always hinge at the hips. Scoop that energy up off the earth. Toss it up to the sky. And bend forward again. And then you can mix it up. So you can have one sunflower. Or moonflower. Totally up to you. We're just getting the blood going. Getting the oxygen to the brain. We started to wake up our core first. Now we're moving it through the whole energy, through the whole body. We'll do 3 more of these wherever you are. Sending those fingertips out nice and long, shoulders are back and down. Taking our hands, putting them to our sides, really bringing those shoulders back. Goddess pose. And we're here, you can drop that booty on down a little bit more if you want to. 3, 2, and 1, lifting all the way up. Star. We are all stars. We are. Right foot rotates in, left foot
rotates out, hip popping it back up to the top of the mat. Taking those hands, putting them down by our side, shoulders go back and down. Finding that strong mountain. Planting those four corners of the feet into the earth, feeling the energy flow up and down. Fingertips come down, they come all the way up, palms reach and kiss overhead to rain them down by our sides, palms finding the earth, stepping back with our left foot and our right foot and our left foot. Plank pose for 3, 2, 1. Here, taking that vinyasa or going straight to downward dog. We'll meet in downward dog. Taking this right foot and extending it up behind us into a three-legged dog. Fingertips are clawing into the earth. Trying not to collapse onto one side or the other. And then bringing this right foot all the way up and through and to the center of your hands. Now, if you're like, what? You can always walk that foot up. No problem. Spinning around on that left back foot for a 45-degree angle, making sure this right knee is over the right ankle, feeling this grounding, the stability. And then once you find your balance, lifting up off of the earth. Ooh, fingertips come and they can kiss overhead gently, bringing them down in prayer position. Anjali Mudra at the heart. Warrior One. Hip points are facing the edge of the mat. Our feet are really ripping the earth apart. Earth part? Well, our mat part. Being sure not to crank into this lower back, but everything is nice and lifted. Warrior One, where we are kind for ourselves, and we have strength for ourselves. So warrior poses are for strength. Building that strength and endurance. And a deep inhale, opening up fingertips, going out to the sides of us. Our hip points are facing edge of the mat. Shoulders are back and down. Warrior Two, gazing out over this right hand. Where we are strong for others, where we are kind to others. You need to adjust, go through your checkpoints. Think about ripping the mat apart, lifting up through that pelvic floor, pulling those shoulders back. Pretend like someone's pulling your pinkies back. And then reaching forward with that right hand coming up and back. Peaceful. Warrior. Deep inhale, coming back to that warrior two, and then cartwheeling it all the way back down, palms finding the earth, rotating on that left back foot, walking that foot in, straightening this right leg as much as you can. And if you're like, wow, that's not straightening, it's okay. No problems. Taking this head, your sweet head, and sending it towards your knee. Feeling the stretch. Putting a little bend in both knees, taking this left foot and walking it up to meet the right. We'll roll up, all the way up, fingertips come, and boop, kiss overhead raining down. By our sides, palms finding the earth. Stepping back with the left foot and the right foot. Plank pose or half plank, and we're here for 3, 2, 1. Going straight to down dog, or you got it, taking that little vinyasa. We'll meet in down dog. Huddling it out. Then taking this left heel and sending it to the back edge of the mat. So lifting it up, really lifting it up. Three-legged dog and breathing. And if you're like, you know, this doesn't feel kind to me, drop that heel and find your downward dog. No worries. And then moving that foot up between those palms, rotating on that right back foot. Left knee is over left ankle. Really feeling that center, finding your gravity, lifting up. Fingertips come to kiss overhead, bringing them down, oh, to our hearts. In Anjali Mudra, everything is lifting. Again, feeling that mat rip apart with our feet. I know it's not a very kind thing to say, but it definitely gives another layer of strength to this warrior pose. And also protects us. Oh, being kind to yourself. So lovely. And a deep inhale, opening up into that warrior two, hands out nice and long beside us, gazing over those left front hands, hip points reaching towards the edge of the mat, shoulders back and down. Somebody's pulling those pinkies back, and we're lifting. You can take your fingertips and send somebody some kind thoughts. Because this is where we're strong for others and kind for others. I got lots of people right now in my head. I love you all. Ooh, and then leaning forward with that left hand, bringing it up. Moments of kindness, and it was not even really even thinking about it, because we should be kind without thinking. It's what I teach in my classroom. But it's in those moments that there is so much peace to be found. Our warrior two, and then cartwheeling it all the way down, planting those palms on the earth, spinning that right foot around, walking that right foot in, that left head, you got two heads, that right head comes down to meet the knee, straightening it if you can, if not, no worries, feeling that nice stretch. A little bend in both knees, walking that right foot forward, lifting up all the way up, rolling, using that core to lift, fingertips come and kiss overhead, taking both of those hands, putting them by our sides, swimming that right hand around and that left hand
hand around. Open up that heart space. If your fingertips grasp, great. If they don't, no worries. Have them right here, or just behind you, or just reach behind you. Maybe you want to take your arms like this and open your chest space like this. Totally up to you. And I'm putting a little bend in those knees if you want a bit more. Carving a line with that nose looking forward, taking those hands up to the sky. Head comes down to the earth. And we're breathing. And again, if this is too much for you, no worries. Stay lifted. Dropping those hands to the earth if you're there. If not, finding that forward fold, luxuriating in that forward fold. Stepping back with the right foot and the left foot. Plank pose or a half plank, yogi's choice, and you got it. Going straight to down dog or taking that vinyasa. Then walking forward with the left foot and the right, left and right meeting in that forward fold, finding that feet to ground connection, rolling up slowly, fingertips come to kiss overhead, raining them down by our sides. Left palm swims around, right palm swims around. Funky thumb on top. So whatever thumb you didn't put on top before, find that thumb, pulling it back and down, open up that chest space. And then again, if you'd like a bit more, taking that nose, carving a line, looking forward, sending those fingertips up towards the sky, putting as much bend in those knees as you need to. Nobody says you got straight. Whew, luxuriate in that stretch. Releasing those hands to the ground. Palms come to the earth. Left leg steps back. Right foot steps back. Finding plank or half plank. Totally yogi's choice. For 3, 2, and 1, going straight to down dog, or you got it, taking that vinyasa. Paddling it out, downward dog, walking forward with the right and left, rolling up all the way up. Fingertips come and bump, kiss overhead, raining them down by our sides with wiggle. Work it out, stepping back with our right foot. What? Yes. Knowing the earth is there. See, it caught me. Taking it and putting it on that 45 degree angle. Left knee is over left ankle. So shoulders are back and down. Dropping the center point. We're back into our warrior one. Kindness for ourselves. Hip points facing the front. This is good for you and you want to stay right here and do so. You want a little bit more and take those hands and wrap them around our body, dropping those shoulders like we did, opening up that heart space. And if you're like, okay, here is good, or maybe here, maybe you just want to grab your elbows, absolutely can do that too. Or maybe you're like, no, I'll just, you know, hang out right here. That's good too. And then if you would like to, bend forward, taking these knuckles up. We're going to come to the inside of our left leg. Making sure we're grounded and stable. Palms up towards the sky. Humble warrior. Here. Feeling very humbled, but also it's in those moments sometimes of humbleness that we find the kindness. Whew, just for two.
and one lifting up using that core. As we come, releasing those hands, fingertips can come up to kiss overhead, bringing them down to our hearts. Let's open up into a nice warrior two. Fingertips slipping by our sides. Reaching forward with that left hand, finding that peace. And cartwheeling it all the way down. Palms finding the earth, moving that, spinning that right foot forward, walking it up, all the way up to meet the left. Finding that forward fall, shaking your heads yes and no, earth to foot connection, rolling up, fingertips come and kiss, low overhead, bringing them down by our sides, wiggle, stepping back with that, you got it, left foot, knowing the earth is there, putting it on that 45 degree angle, right knee is over right ankle. And if maybe you weren't so stable during that last one, you're like a little more stability, you can always widen this warrior one stance. So moving that left foot out just a bit, so dropping our pelvis down, right knee is over right ankle, finding that stability, hands right here, Anjali Mudra at the heart. Warrior one, strong for ourselves. And if this is where you want to stay, stay there. If you'd like a bit more, cognizantly put those shoulders back and down, swimming those arms behind us. I'm going to invite you to put the funky thumb on top this time. Clasping those hands together. And if this is good for you, stay right there. If you'd like a bit more, you can always lean forward, picking those arms up to the sky. And if your body is shaking or trembling a little bit here, awesome. Some people in this can bring their heads all the way to the earth. Fantastic. If you are at that level, I invite you to do so. If you are not, that is okay too. And we're here for 3, 2, and 1. Using that core to come all the way back. Fingertips break free, low, come up overhead, bring them down to our hearts. Opening up into that warrior two. Breathing, reaching forward, into warrior. Spinning on that left back foot, putting a little bend in both knees, walking that left foot up to meet that right, luxuriating in that forward fold again, lifting up all the way up, fingertips come and kiss overhead, bringing them down by our side, swan diving forward as our fingertips, our whole palms kiss the ground, and we step back with our right foot and our left foot dropping down to our knees. Walking our hands back, all the way up, shoulders come back and down. Taking our hands and pushing them up behind our heads, letting them gently float down to the ground. And then on another deep inhale, hands come up overhead, kissing. Right hand comes to right thigh, left hand swims around. A gentle twist. Coming back to center, rotating everything back to center. Hands come up behind.
two, exhaling as left hand finds right thigh and right hand spins around.
And then reaching those hands out, actually up behind our ears again, walking them out, finding child's pose. Head comes to the earth. And if you want to stay right here, I absolutely invite you to do so. If you'd like to do what is called a Namaste Shark Fin in some cases, you can walk those elbows out, clasp those hands behind your head, or clasp them, just kind of namaste them. Anjali, well, they're not really at the heart, but walk those elbows forward and build a shark fin behind your head. And if you need to look at me, absolutely do so. Whew. Stretching. So grateful you took this time out for yourself. Reaching those hands forward again. Walking them back up. We'll come to a crisscross applesauce. Our hands. Deep inhale as they come all the way up. Palms kiss overhead. We bring them down to our forehead, where we hope we cultivate faith and think kind thoughts. To our mouths. Where we hope we speak kindness to ourselves and others, and to our hearts, where in the kindness we hope we are humbled, so that all the world can see us. Thank you so much for taking this time with me. And for yourself. And be with spirit.